What's up, guys? Click the subscribe button and press the bell icon to stay updated with our videos. Hello, students, and welcome back to BankExamsToday.com. So today I'm going to give you 5 tips to start your preparations. And if you're already doing your preparations, these 5 tips are going to help you in preparation of Bank of India credit officer exam, right? So my first tip to all the students is stop using the calculators. I know that many of you are chartered accountants, many of you are company secretaries, many of you are like MBA in finance from very good institutes. But what if I ask you a simple question? Just tell me that, see, you have 1000 rupees, right? And rate of interest is, let's say, 7%. How much time it will take to quadruple or triple the sum of money? How much time it will take? So that's the question you are going to find in the real exam. I mean, I saw that question in last year's paper. So these are the type of questions that you are going to find in the actual exams. Or let's take it in another way. Every month I'm giving you 500 rupees and the rate of interest is 7%. So for the next 5 years, I gave you 500 rupees every month. So what is the present value of all that sum of money that I gave you, that I'm going to give you? What is the present value? In another way, what is the future value? Without using the calculators, without getting that NOT tables, can you solve this? It's your take. So stop using calculators. The eligibility criteria of this exam is so tough that I have got a lot of calls from chartered accountants and company secretaries for whom these kind of questions are nothing. I mean, they are really good at accounts and they are really good at financial management. They just don't need our help. But still, they use KLC at all the times. Right. So that's the problem number one, or the tip number one. Stop using the calculators. Use your brain, use your mind. It is a habit. The second thing, stop using the basic general awareness knowledge, general awareness capsule or the GK digest or the GK capsules that are meant for IBPS PO or SBI PO. Don't use that. This exam is little different. This is not what you, I mean, this is not the normal list of important days, you know, list of schemes and all. No, not at all. It's broader. The kind of websites that you should follow is like Investopedia, is like RBI's official website, is NABARD's official website, SEBI's official website, PIB's. These are the sort of websites that you should follow for the preparation of your exam. Right. Of course, Bank Exams Today, because we have prepared a complete course for this. We do analysis of Investopedia. We do analysis of RBI's official website. We do analysis of PIBs. And we also teach how to solve the questions without using the calculator. We provide the complete test series and notes, everything. Everything is available on BankExamsToday.com. So these are few, you know, useful websites for your exam preparations. Stop, you know, using your course books, the CA modules and all. Those books are meant for case studies, not for MCQ kind of questions. So that's my second tip. The third one, obviously, get a proper course, either by Team Bank Exams Today or any other person, right? See, most of you are working professionals. You don't have that much of time to prepare your own notes or, you know, prepare your own or find the best books. It is not even possible. I mean, by the time you are able to complete your notes or by the time you are able to, you know, find the reliable source of information, the time will be gone. You have just, I think, less than a month now. You don't have that much of time. So there are people like Bank Exams Today. Many other people are available there on the internet. Internet is a sea, is an ocean actually. So it is an ocean of information. You need to choose the right person who can actually help you. Or he can be your, you know, he can be your friend, he can be your father, he can be your sister. find the right person, or you know, find a proper guidance who can actually guide you. Maybe you're already a chartered accountant, maybe you're already a company secretary, but do you have that much of time to do it yourself? I mean, doing it yourself is the best thing, but you need time for that. If you have time, then you don't need any, you shouldn't watch that video as well. Just go on, right? Then the next thing, banking awareness is, and financial awareness as well, is actually very important, not just for this exam, also for the interview levels. Whatever the RBI is doing, right? Whatever the notification, let it be like Swaption, Bharat ETF 22, or there is a notification by SEBI. I mean, I heard, you know, a lot of students just ask me, sir, should I just do RBI's notifications? This is a literally a confusing question, actually, right? The recategorization of mutual funds is actually the most important notification or the most important banking awareness topic of the whole, you can say, whole year, actually, whole 2018. I mean, even 2017, it was out in 2017 and implemented in 2018. That's the most important question. The recategorization notification by SEBI, it was actually disastrous, or, you know, complete overhaul of whole mutual fund industry. Two or three other notifications is like a mutual fund distributor cannot be an investment advisor, right? So there are two, three really amazing notifications that are actually very important for this exam. So are you aware about these notifications? If your answer is yes, then you're already reading the banking awareness. You're already aware about the banking industry. You're already aware about the financial industry. I mean, see, reading banking awareness is not like just pick a financial newspaper and read it every day, read Business Today. No, this is your awareness regarding the banking industry and the finance industry, financial industry. What is happening in the capital market? What is happening in the banking industry? You should be aware about the PCA, on which, I mean, you should be aware about what are the various committees that were were set up for the corporate governance. What is Kumar Mangalam Birla's committee? What is like Narayan Murthy's committee? What they recommended? What is Basel III norms? What were Basel II norms? What is Basel? What are the various, you know, reports released by World Bank, by IMF, by UNESCO? I mean, what is the rank of India? How is India doing? How Indian government is helping? What is Indradhanush scheme? How Indian government is supporting the banking industry? I mean, how is Indian government regulating the financial and the banking industry? Are you aware about these topics? If your answer is yes, then you're already doing good. So that was the current affairs and the banking and the financial industry. The next point, the important one. See, students, I know a lot of you are chartered accountants and they don't consider me or my team as, you know, a teacher, but please listen to me now. A lot of you actually, you called me and told me that, sir, I'm preparing for this exam just to grab the knowledge. Is it? Are you just starting? Are you just, you know, giving your like 4-5 hours every day from last a month or a half, or maybe from last 5-6 days, and you're going to invest your time into this exam just for the sake of knowledge? If you're doing that, you are doing a big mistake. See, I am very much interested in mutual funds. I'm very much interested in venture capital chapters. These two chapters are actually very important for me. So I am reading the various reports or the PhD thesis or the MBA thesis of international level, or, you know, from the universities in India. So I'm trying to enhance my knowledge. I'm not going to appear for any exam. You know, gaining knowledge is a long-term process, but you don't have that much of time. You cannot gain knowledge within a month. You should focus at your exam. For example, from cost of capital chapter, the important questions are, first of all, how to calculate the cost of redeemable preference shares, or how to calculate the most important question, the weighted average cost of capital. You are going to find this question in the exam. Just mark it down. The weighted average cost of capital. You are going to find this question in the exam. Just mark my words. There's some other questions are like annuities. In all the FM papers, which are MCQs, you are going to find one WACC, weighted average cost of capital. One question related to EPS NPE ratios, and one question related to annuities, future values, present values. Then there will be a questions from FDI policy. Yes, in the FM there will be a question from FDI policy, because there are some recent changes in FDI policy. Then swaptions, that the notification released by RBI, any change in that IIP base years or what, all the important notifications by RBI and SEBI, there can be questions from that. Last year there were a lot of questions from capital structure and cost of capital, so there was a rumor that the exam was from cost accounting, but no, this cost of capital and capital structure, these chapters are from financial management and not from cost accounting. So beware of such things. So these were my, you know, five basic suggestions. I request all of you, actually all of you, don't waste your time on the internet. I mean, many of you are going to online forums and asking each other, or you know, calling your seniors, or there are some CAs who are just calling their friends, just buddy, tell me what to study for this exam. They don't know. I mean, they themselves don't know. How can they tell you? For the general awareness, if you are just downloading the current affairs, if you are reading just that thing plus starting GK, you are doing a mistake. That's not what you should do. So that's what my recommendation is for you. I mean, avoid the rumors, you know, avoid that study material that was just prepared for IBPS or SBI PU level exams. The difficulty level of the Bank of India exam, I mean, credit officer, it's not that difficult, but the syllabus is different. The first thing, read the international reports. The second thing, read the schemes, reports and schemes, whatever the reports and schemes, you know, released by the Indian government, what are the various government schemes by central government, that is important. That's what you need to do. Static GK up to a mark, it's okay, but the notifications by RBI, SEBI, NABARD and the various PIBs, that is actually important. That's what you need to do. See, right now what we are doing is, I have already told you, I'm not going to promote my course too much. I can't overdo the things. So, a course is available. So, what right now I am doing is, for the FM part, I am preparing the, short notes. I have done everything in depth. But now, for the practical topics, I am just making 100 questions, out of which I am expecting that at least 7-8 questions will be there from those 100 questions. And one of those the questions are like WACC, EPS. You are going to find questions from that. So that's what I'm doing right now, and I'm going to provide those questions to all my students, right? So if you want to join our course, join a proper classes kind of a thing, you know, if you want to get a proper well-researched notes, so you can get a, first of all, I request all of you to take a demo. Just go to bankexamstoday.com and just make your account. If you have a mobile device, just install BankExamsToday's mobile application and take a demo. I mean, we have provided the free classes, free notes and a free test. If you are satisfied with those notes and classes, then you can actually join the course. My number is, students, 906720100. That is my personal number. In case you need any kind of help, you can actually call me, even if you are not going to join my course. If you have any other doubt related to the exam, you can actually call me. So students, that's all for today. I mean, it's really hot. So you can actually, you know, click the like button, click the subscribe button, and there is a bell icon. Press that bell icon. And in case you have any other doubt, you can call me or you can post a comment. I'm going to reply all your comments tomorrow. So that's all for today, students. Thank you and have a very nice day. Bye.